darkness till the break of day. And I need that fire just to know that I'm awake. Until we go down. Until we go down. Until we go down. Until we go down.
Yeah, my throat's still sore. My throat's still very, very sore. But I'm glad I gave it a day's rest at least. I think that helps it, to be honest. Giving it a day's rest. Sorry, I'm a little bit out of breath. I was doing jumping jacks, honest. Maybe some cold soup and hot veg will help. Yeah, gravy, possibly. Yeah, I am totally infected, to be honest. Hey Warped, how you doing? Hey Literally Hilter, how you doing? And Brian S. and Groovy. Good to see all you guys. Hope you're all okay. Hope you're all having a good day. Ready for another bit of 7 days to die, I think. Well, obviously we had yesterday off. I did tweet it out that we had yesterday off, but many people that watch me don't follow on Twitter or don't have a Twitter account, don't do the tweeting thing at all, which I understand, you know, which is okay. Yeah, I did like that, Grimmy. Yes, I did. That's very good. Right, 7 days to die. Excuse me. Oh my god, my throat, I swear. It's so bad. But yeah, we're doing our best with our sore throat, to be honest. We're doing our best. can't find my treasure in 7 days, did I? Well, I find mine quite easy, Darath. I thought it was quite simple, really. Just a bit of triangulation, bit of mathematics. It was easy. It was easy. It was easy to find. You need to use your mathematical side. I didn't interact with them at all, literally. Not at all. Nope, nope. Didn't even go near them. It's okay, it's fine. They're safe. They're totally safe. Totally, they are safe. Let the gravel stream commence, exactly. The voice like death. So, of course, let's go through our settings. As we always do at the start of a stream, just so that people know what settings I do play under. So difficulty settings is insane. It is the one down the bottom there. Daylight length is 18 hours, which cuts down just a little bit on the dead time at night in the stream. Moderate options, we have 24-hour cycle as every 60 minutes. Every 60 minutes is one complete day in the game. Gives us a chance to have our break every hour as we do a bit of responsible gaming. Loot abundance is at 25%, so as hence what's in the title. That's a lot less loot than per normal. Enemy spawning is very high, hence the 150% that goes into our title as well. And airdrops are disabled because they're OP as fuck. They just are. It's just the way it is. Yeah, you've been on a 3-week vacation from family. Yeah, exactly. That's what the doctor advised anyway. 3-week vacation from the family. Like, what? Really? Like, who can do that? Who can really do that? Hey, Tactical Beaver, how you doing? Good to see you. Good to see you here. Right, let's get started. I can't even remember what we were doing. But I was thinking this morning, and I'm thinking about the Day 14 Horde that's imminent. It is today, isn't it, I think? It's imminent, I think. So, we could do with building some more of those, some more of the platforms for the Day 14 Horde, and extending things slightly, I think. I feel we could be in trouble if we don't. But we'll see how we go on that one, I think. I guess. Of course, it's night time because we stop at night time. That's normally when we stop the stream. So it's a good time to stop. Means when we log back in again, we haven't got any imminent dangers or worries. We're just sort of hanging around our house doing what we need to do. Let's check out our food and stuff. Food is good. Water is not. Let's have a drink. Hey, Athene Life. How you doing, bro? Good to see you, man. How's things going with the site? I hope they're going really well. I have to say, they really should, Tactical. It's a bloody good film, isn't it? Wasn't it? It was a bloody good film, right? I really loved it. Really loved it. Like, I wish it was a feature film. I wish it was an entire thing. They did such a really good job on it. Didn't they? Did anyone else think that? Did anyone else watch the Division short film and think, they should have made a feature film out of that? That actually would have been amazing. It was fucking good. It was good. It was so damn good, right? So damn good, you know? Oh, man, it was amazing. I'm sure most of you know him anyway, but for those who don't know Athene, he is a guy that does a lot of charity stuff here on Twitch. We took part in one of his charity drives just recently, if you remember. Gamingforgood.net. If you type !GFG, you'll still have the link there to my exact page on gamingforgood.net. You can donate there if you wish to donate to charity. That's always active. That's always alive. So if you ever want to talk, if you ever want to donate to charity, if you ever feel like you wish to donate, then feel free to do so. And the link is always there. It's not gone anywhere. So it's going good. Still talking to people, but feedback, Athene Live, I'm not sure you want this feedback. I do have a guy who is normally a regular in my chat, but he's on vacation. Actually, he's on a business trip at the minute for about 3 or 4 days, and he'll be back in the next couple of days, Athene. And he is extremely, he's a computer programmer for a living, right? And he's an old geezer. He's, you know, maybe 50, 60 years old, and he knows his stuff. He's been doing this for a fucking long time, right? Computer programming. And he said the site was a nightmare, because he obviously, he doesn't donate necessarily through the normal, just Twitch, click, and donate, and all that kind of thing. He goes through multiple VPNs, etc., to get through. Thank you, Snap, for the host, man. Amazing. And Jag, thank you for the host. I thought Jag was streaming. How is he hosting? Anyway, thank you so much for the hosts. I appreciate those. That's very, very kind of you. Hey, you didn't snap. But Okro Express was saying that he had a nightmare thing to try and get through and donate. He found it very, very cumbersome to try and donate using the methods that he would normally donate via. So he hated it. He called you many names. But he did donate. He did donate to charity. He was one of my biggest donators, and he is an absolute hero. But he had a lot of complaints about the website, actually, I think, to be honest. Technical stuff that I don't understand. Very technical stuff. And I didn't understand it at all. I was hoping he might have been here when you were here sometime so that he could explain it to you, because I don't understand it. I didn't understand what it was, you know. Hey, Avrand, how you doing? Good to see you. Jack just finished up. Ah, right. Because believe it or not, Jack, I only just 2 minutes ago, maybe 3 minutes ago, Jack, I just got a tweet from Coleman's saying you were live. And I clicked on your channel and there you were. And I thought, oh, so Jag's just started up. And you've just finished. I've only just got the tweet. What you need to do, Jag Zero, is you need to tweet at Coleman's and say, if you're going to retweet it, then fucking do it on time. He's only just tweeted, at least I've only just got it on my Twitter, that you were going live. So what? Yeah, I've only just started, so I'll be streaming for a while. Yeah, I'll definitely be streaming for a while. To be honest, Athene, he is a professional. He is so fucking good. He knows his stuff inside out, Athene, and he would probably have some really, really great improvements for the site if only I could get you to speak to him. Or get your coders to speak to him. That would be the best. And I'm sure he would want to help if it's for charity, right? But he's not here at the moment. Like I say, he's on vacation at the minute. He's actually in the UK at the minute for like 3 or 4 days with his wife on a business trip. But he'll be back probably in the next couple of days. He normally comes into the channel every day. So if you come back sometime, I think, maybe we can get you in contact with him and get you talking. And that would probably help you out, bro. Really, really would. Because from his point of view, the setup of it was a nightmare. He thought it was just a nightmare, the way it was set up and the way the donations were set up. He hated it. He absolutely hated it from his professional point of view. Do you know what I mean? Like, from my point of view, it's fine, right? You just click and you just donate. That's all cool. So to us normal minions, it all just seems fine. But from his point of view, he thought it was terrible. But yeah, that's another conversation for another time, I feel. All right. Snap, if you just type !GFG, right? You were thinking that Athene's Gaming for Good was like a separate platform. It's not. It takes the feed from Twitch. You don't have to stream to another platform or stream somewhere else. You just stream to Twitch as you normally do. And you will just have another version of your exact same Twitch page on Gaming for Good. And you can dress it up as you want. Just type !GFG, Snapfracklepop. And you'll see my webpage, you'll see my Twitch stream on the Gaming for Good site. And if you, there's then a donation button in the top right-hand corner on that page where people, if they wish to, when there's a, you know, when there's a an incentive going on or when you want to do a charity stream, you just go there and you click on the top right there and you can then donate to charity on that donation link and 100% of that will go to charity. So it's not that you have to stream to another site or anything, Snap. It works exactly the same as here. It takes the Twitch chat. It takes, no, you're not, Snap. Not at all. I do it, bro. So if I do it, you can do it, right? If I do it, you can do it, man. Absolutely. Hey, Sinister, how's it going? Came back from eating and see Snap. So it's absolutely Sinister, yeah. Thank you, Snap, for the host. I do appreciate it. Yes, I am here. I am awake and alive with a really sore throat still. Hey, Big Head, how you doing, man? Yeah, we did what we could, I think, but we are a small people. But it doesn't matter, Snap, even if you have one person that donates $2 to the charity manager, it all builds up, doesn't it, right? It doesn't matter who donates or how much donates. It's, or even if you just stream with the Gaming for Good thing up on top, when there's an incentive going on, when there's something going on that we need to all get behind, if you stream just with the Gaming for Good in your title and stuff, it brings it to people's attention. So even if You don't necessarily get the donations through your channel, which I'm sure you would anyway. But even if you don't get them through your channel, it's about getting visibility out there, isn't it? And at a time like that, right, there's some kind of thing going on where we all need to get behind as a community, as we did do fairly recently, which there was an incredible amount raised at that time. Yes, it can, Athene. Yeah, they have. When someone donates at the Gaming for Good site, there's a little slider and they can change it. So if they donated $10, they can change it so 50% goes to you and 50% goes to charity if they wish. The donator can choose. It's up to them. I have it set by default as 100% goes to charity. So if you do donate at the Gaming for Good website, then 100% of it goes to charity. Absolutely, Slade. Every little bit does help, right? Eat honey. Clear's Cathedral Stage 1. It's not rare now. Snap, I noticed just before... Snap, Frackopop, just before I switched over to my channel here, I heard you saying that hornets don't drop honey anymore. They do. You have to harvest them with a knife, exactly the same as deer and rabbits and chickens and all that. You have to harvest them. So if you kill a hornet, you have to harvest it, and you get the honey off it. You get a jar of honey off a harvested hornet. So you do still get honey off a hornet, bro. You just got to harvest it, that's all. So it is still there. You do still get honey. It's not a rare drop or anything. Yeah, it's a happy day. Absolutely. Yeah, you can still get it all. So it's still there. It's not a it's not an impossible thing anymore. Because you can't even access the body anymore, can you? You can't even open it like a loot crate anymore. It's not accessible. And I thought, well, that's a bit weird. And I tried to harvest it, and it worked. So you can harvest it now. Yeah, you got to cut the honey gland out. Exactly. I don't know, Vildik. It's an apocalypse. What? You're worried about how the hornets make honey when the hornet is the same size as me? I'm not going to question it. It's a massive hornet. I don't know. It's somehow mutated into some kind of weird honeybee, hornety, big, massive thing the size of me. I'm not going to question it. It is what it is. Yeah, so if you kill any hornets, you got to harvest the darn things. I mean, honestly, in that entire situation, I think the last thing I'm questioning is how do they make honey? They're massive, and they're trying to sting me. Kill them. Harvest them for whatever you can get. I believe you also get rotten flesh off them as well, Snap. I think you get rotten flesh and you get honey. That's what I've had when I harvested one. Bee stinged arrows. Yeah, that would be kind of cool, right? Where does the jar come from? These mutated bees are able to also blow glass, and they make their own jars. They're really, really talented bees, honestly. They're very talented bees. They're much more talented than your average bee, and than any normal bee you might have seen before. They're much more talented. They're very good, these bees. They can make their own jars. They're quite incredible, honestly. Right. Excuse me, all the coughing and stuff. I really do apologize, but it's, you know, I'm just dying. I'm sorry. But I am slowly dying. Hopefully not in a literal sense, but certainly in the metaphorical sense right now. The dying is real. Let's put those in there. Let's put those there. We need to smelt up a whole bunch of that, I think. Or maybe even put some small stones in the cement mixer and get that going. To get sand, possibly. I'd like to switch to concrete sooner rather than later, if I can. I have done one treasure quest, Darath. Yes, I did. I did one treasure quest there 2 days ago. Not yesterday, the day before. It's not man flu, Jack Zero. I have some sort of weird infection of my vocal cords. My vocal cords are shot. Hey, Zeril, how you doing? Oh my god. Maybe they make it like a chicken makes eggs. Maybe they do, Bri. Maybe they make it how the Easter Bunny makes chocolate eggs. I don't know. Who's to know? Who's to know about these things? How deep underground? It's Darath, it's between the rock layer and the surface. It's not below the rock layer. So it's only in the dirt layer, the top few layers, Darath. It's only the top few layers. It's not really low. It's so from all the ones that I've seen dug up. Snap Frackle dug one up. I dug one up, and I saw one dug up on another stream as well. And they were all in the dirt layers, in the top dirt layers. So yeah, use the treasure hunting perk, which gives you a radii. Basically, I have the first tier of treasure hunting, and it means that I detect the treasure within 11 blocks, right? So all I did was I saw that, let's say that block, that box there was the treasure. I got to where it started to flash and say, I'm at the treasure. I put a frame down. I went over here and said, where does it say when I get the, and I put a frame down. And then I went over this direction and I said, how far away until it flashes? And then I put a frame down. And I basically triangulated where the treasure must be and then dug down at that spot. And I got it quite quickly. I got it pretty easily, to be honest. That's the easiest way to do it. Hey, Predator, how you doing, man? Good to see you. Great to see you here today. Hope you're all having a great day today. It's good to see every single one of you. It is morning time. Let's go. I don't even know where I'm going or why I'm going, but let's go. It makes sense to go. Right. I think I need to put stones into my cement mixer and get cement mixing. I think that would make a sensible thing to do, right? To try and get the old... How do I know how many I'm doing? Okay, so I've just got to... Let's go for 200. Whoa, go for it, cement mixer. That's a weird sound. Anyone else keen on the cement mixer sound? That's a very odd sound. Pretty good, you broke your 7 days to die. That's not good. Hey, Ho Hulk, how you doing? Good to see you. Oh. Luckily, I just had 10 points. I purchased the perk. Excellent. Give it a try. Awesome. How did you break your 7 days to die, exactly? Polistin, I... You social wasps have at least... One species stores honey in the comb. You're just full of so many searches, Slade. Hey, Buck, sorry to hear about your throat. All the best with it. Just on 7 days to die yourself. Awesome, Dawn. No worries. Yeah, the dogs are very nasty. Tactical. I've died twice already to the dogs, man. That sounds really messed up, that cement mixer thing. I'm not keen. Right, concrete mix needs crushed sand, small stones, and cement, right? Well, I have some cement. Okay, obviously not a lot of cement. Some. Let's make some more cement if we can. Bang. Oh shit, there's a whole bunch of fucking wood already in there. Let's take that out. Make some cement in here. Boom. Now, how does this work exactly? So I have stones, and I have cement, and I have crushed sand. Will it take it out of the output? I don't know. It won't. It will. So it has to be in my inventory before I can do it. Okay. Make it, I guess. Go. What a boss. It sounds like a broken washing machine. It does, doesn't it? But it doesn't make any sound when you don't have it open. Look. There's no sound. If I open it, it has sound. If I close it, it doesn't have sound. Does that mean it doesn't work unless I open it? It was on 17, wasn't it? No, it still works when I don't open it. It just doesn't make a sound if I don't open it. Okay, that's a bit strange. Hey, Chupa de Marango, how's it going? How you doing? But, you know, we had a day off to try and give it a bit of a rest yesterday. I don't know why doing that helps, but apparently it does. Apparently if you just wave your hand about a little bit, it makes you feel better. You had a motorbike, put a blue engine in it, drove up a hill, over a hill, but I landed and fell through the world. The game crashed and won't load back up. Damn, Predator! Right, Sinistra, there you go. Honey is made. Does the mixer attract zombies? I don't know, but I put it over here just in case it does. I don't know if it does, honestly. I'm not sure. But I was skeptical and thought, well, maybe it does, I thought I'd put it over here. I'm a little bit worried because I could be attracting the little screamer zombies and I can't deal with that right now. Concrete mix. Go. Crushed sand. Go. Crush all the sand. Right. So now we've got a little bit of concrete mix, which is like, wow. Well, hello. So we and I make these, right? Does anyone know what the cheapest way to reinforce concrete is? Is it still concrete block, just concrete? Is that the best way now? I'm a bit suspect, I'll be honest. Let's make one. And we'll take our stone axe. We'll place it, see if we can upgrade it, see what happens. I'm not sure what will happen. So there's one. I'd kind of like to reinforce that one, have another gap, and then have two reinforced, and then a block. So this is kind of like where I'd want the next blocks, I think, to be. Right, with a 5 gap between. So, 10 concrete mix, and I've now got a reinforced concrete block. Done. Apparently. Let's make 3 more of those. We can make a pillar right now, which is perfect. It's quite slow to craft these, eh? Obviously, when you get the perk for faster crafting, that'll help out a little bit. Hey, another elk, how you doing? Good to see you. Beautiful. And there we have another pillar. Obviously, it takes a little bit to dry, and when it dries, all that wood comes off, and you just get reinforced concrete left behind, which is perfect. A rebar frame will only cost 1 scrap iron to produce. So reinforced concrete costs only 1 scrap iron, 10 wood, concrete mix. So rebar frame is the better way to do it, is it, Jerry? Although it's using iron rather than just stone, but it's the better way then, I guess. I know another elk. I'm worried about it myself, I'll be honest with you. Especially with the fact that I smoke and all that. I went to the doctor and I was fearing the worst, you know, as you do. But she just went, no, it's just a really bad throat infection that we have going around at the moment. It's a lot of people have it. You'll be fine. And I'm thinking, yeah, I'm not sure if I really trust you, to be honest. But whatever. We're here. We're alive at the moment. Hey, you Baji, how you doing, bro? Good to see you. Hey, Pawn. Did I say hello, Decisive One? Because I'm sure I did. I saw what you typed, and I can't remember if I said hello or not. But if I didn't, I apologize, and hello to you. Yeah, rebar might actually be the way to go, to be honest, because we'll probably be able to get enough iron to do the rebar frames. Yeah, the rebar might be the way to go, quite honestly. Might have to look into that, bro. That might be an idea. And we already have 4 rebar frames to spare. So, we could do another. We could do another pillar. Right off the bat here. Right. Let's get some more of the old concrete mix. Oh, this is very annoying. Apparently I'm stuck here. Okay, I can't have that. That's better. Can't be stuck. If we're stuck, then the zombies start digging. Absolutely, Steven. If it happens, I'll be confiscating all the cigarettes I can, I'll be honest. I'll be confiscating all the cigarettes, bro. Right, that and that. So we need more stones in order to do more concrete mix, right? More stones required. Little axe, where are you? Thank you. Cement's drying very fast. Doesn't seem to be drying very fast, bro. It hasn't dried for me yet. There we go, there's 2 more pillars, which is awesome. That's cool. That's cool. We need stone. Why am I... What's wrong with her? She's complaining a lot. Pick. Seriously, stop the complaining. You're starting to annoy me now. Where's my next... We need more stones. Lots more stones needed. The cement mixer, I have to say, I know it maybe doesn't make logical sense, but I kind of wish that it had, I kind of wish that it had an input box to store a load of stuff on input or something. Having to have it just in your inventory and just click it in, that feels wrong. It's annoying. I don't know why. I have no idea why. I haven't had a chance to see the new ores yet, but as you know, I haven't seen a thing, bro. I haven't seen a bloody thing. Right. I can't actually see a thing. Literally. So, torches. That's one. Skip. That would be one. And then the next one down. Okay, so I've got to go another one. Whack. And torch. There we go. Now we've got a bit more light again. A lot of stone. Yeah, I will need a lot of stone. They said in the recent patch they changed the look of them or something, didn't they? Didn't they say that, I think? One of the patches. What's that? Is that an ore? Or is that stone? I can't tell. I think it's stone, obviously, because I'm not getting anything from it, but... It looked weird. They said they tried to change the coloration so that it's not so so discolored underground. But I mean, this looks very yellow. Everything looks the freaking same, very yellow. I don't know. I'm not convinced. Not wholly convinced about that. But to be honest, I think that's realistic. I don't necessarily want them to fix that. Does that make sense? Do you know what I'm saying? And g'day Rattle, how you doing, bro? Shit. not sure why that looks like two different colored wood frames. We have a random dick. Just a random dick. It's a random dick, not a horde. Oh, fuck. Well, that sorted him out. Random dick gone. Random dick dealt with. Know what am I saying? Thank you, Decisive. I appreciate that honesty. No, I kind of like the fact that it's sort of discolored and yellow down here. Doesn't that seem realistic to you? If it was a nice clear white color, it would seem wrong, wouldn't it? You know, you've got just a torch burning. It should look kind of discolored and yellow and a bit off and difficult to see. And I think it's quite atmospheric, to be honest. I think it looks good. It's correct. Almost. Do you know what I mean? I don't necessarily want them to fix that. Does that make sense? I think if they fix that, it wouldn't be good. I think the lighting there is... This is pretty good to me. This looks ideal for me, in my opinion. Yeah, maybe we need the... for the ore, Shibaji, maybe we need it to look like a different... Like, surface, almost. You know? Like, bitmapping, like, you know, like to make it look more... pronounced or jagged or something like that front ore. So it actually, you know, the way this looks like a bumped surface, right? It does look like a sort of a rough surface. Maybe they need it to look like a different feel of a surface rather than the look of a surface. Does that, I'm probably again just making not sense. Making not sense? Well, that shows that I was making not sense, really. The fact that I said I was making not sense. The old ones were nice, yeah, you bet. Yeah. But the old ones only worked because of the fact you could see them. If you can't see them, the old ones wouldn't be all that good. You need to be able to see it. Otherwise, you know, seeing is believing. What? I don't know. It just sounded like a good thing to say at the time. Seeing is believing. I'm overheating. For friggin'. Seriously? Let's take our leather duster off for now. What's the point in them? Nope. Why did that? No point whatsoever in them. Awesome. Well, we'll wear them then. I mean, that makes sense. If there's no point in them, let's get them on our face. So the next one. Is when it would be. Now I need another pick, don't I? Because this one's kaput. This one has come to an end, I believe. Yeah, I know. It's obviously texture, you know, making it seem. Like a different surface would be rather tricky. I'm not saying it would be easy. I'm just saying that would be a way to differentiate it and keep the coloring as it is. Because I think the coloring is a good thing. I don't see the coloring as a bad thing. That's the problem. That's what I mean. We'll whack that down so we can see what the hell we're doing now. That makes it hard for me to make tunnels, bunker or brow spots. Okay, well, I understand what you mean, Sinister. But I think it looks pretty damn good, to be honest with you. Hey, Shadow King, how you doing? I think it looks pretty damn good. I like it. Obviously, that's probably just a personal preference thing, right? But I like it, bro. I like the look it gives it. I like the feel of it. The whole thing. I think they've done a good job, and I'm impressed. Twitch messed up just recently, Shadow King, so some of my just recent broadcasts aren't on YouTube. Because the export button wasn't working, so I couldn't export stuff. I tweeted about it many times, and in fact, I tweeted about the fact that they were ignoring me. Which was a shame. And funny old thing, when I tweeted about them ignoring me, they didn't ignore me. How hilarious was that? I tweeted about a week ago, saying my export and my highlight buttons weren't working. Got no reply, no nothing. And I tweeted again a sort of day or so later and said, yeah, they're still not working. No reply, no nothing. And then I tweeted again and said, oh, if only I was someone important, and then you maybe would read my tweet of the fact that the export button is still not working. And then suddenly there was a tweet by them saying, we've heard the export button's not working, and we're working on it. I'm like, ah, oh, funny old thing. I'm like, ah, oh, weird that, isn't it? What a twerp, man. I was kind of pissed off, I'll be honest. That looks different. Wait, that looks... What's this? Sand? Why am I getting sand? Why am I getting sand? What? Since when do you get sand when you mine? I'm somewhat confusioid. Iron and sand. You get sand from gravel now. What? Where do you get gravel? If you get sand from gravel, where do you get gravel? From sand? This makes no sense. Oh shit, now I've just lost whatever the hell that was. I don't know what it was, but I've lost it. That makes no sense. You can be stunned. I don't know about stun locked, but you can still be stunned, and the stun is still very long. So it's effectively bloody stun locked, right? Because it's so freaking annoying. And it lasts for a very long time, or appears to last for a very long time. Oh my god. That's bad, Daraf. An hour real time digging for a treasure chest? Either you're really bad at triangulating, or it was a really trolley chest, I don't know. I'm gonna go with the bad with triangulating thing, sorry. My lack of faith is probably a bad thing. Should we get some more torches? I don't understand why this is a different color. Have I got different wood down here? Is this like a... I don't know. Is that pine and that's mahogany or something? Have I suddenly got mahogany wood? Apparently I've just got mahogany wood. I do have a mining helmet on. Yeah. I should have used it, huh? Yeah. Okay. Just pretend I was using it the whole time. This is weird. That's... I'm going to assume there's like a metal in there, right? That looks metallic-ish. But it all looks gray. That's weird, that it all looks rather grey. And I can't tell where the sand is. Apparently that was sand. Difficult to tell, though, to be perfectly honest. Whatever. Yeah, apparently I've got some mahogany down here. I've got pine up the top. I've got pine up the top, mahogany down the bottom. Perfect. Just what I wanted. But yeah, find ores. Find ore! That's not a bad thing. We need to... Shit, zombies. Yo, zombies, what are you doing? I'm just trying to get some cement, zombies. You just hang around, bros. You just calm yourselves down. Don't come near me. Don't come near me. I'm doing my own thing. Concrete mix? Why only 85? What have I run out of? I ran out of concrete. Cement. I ran out of cement. 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 Concrete mix. Now what have I run out of? Stone, sand? Okay. Okay. Sand. Over 300 sand. Dude! Aww. Oh, dude. See what you did? You see what you did? You just... Yeah. That was just useless. That was pointless. A waste of your time. And my time, to be honest. Hey, Shelby, how you doing? No, they're in random gen as well, Pawn. They were kind of inefficient, Sinistra, but they have improved them. They have improved them, honestly. Dude. Dude. Can you see the floor actually? The floor looks like it's spongy. Is that just my imagination? He's freaking out. Dude. He's one of these people that are just really determined. And he's just really determined. He really, 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 really wants to get up on that. Yeah. He's a very determined kind of fellow. What is it for rebar? Iron and clay. We've got both of, right? Should we try and make some rebar right now? How many can I make? 522 of them. That seems like a lot of rebar. Let's make 522 of them. Sounds like a really good plan. Mixer battery's low. You don't even put a battery in it. You put an engine in it, but you don't put a battery in it. I don't know. And the juice stained spikes. They're stupid. That's ridiculous. The pink on them spikes is... Honest to God, you're starting to annoy me. And you're attracting attention. Dude. See, you've attracted a lot of attention now. See what you did? You see what you gone and did? See what you gone and did. Twerp. Okay, so it's not the fastest thing in the world, the old cement mixer, but it does the job, right? Not the fastest thing in the world, but it certainly does the job. Okay. These guys are just enjoying themselves. On the, on the spike field of love. You done? Okay, he's done. Alright, good. He's done. put that there again. Let's go. The zombies can jump, right? Hey, Nalith, how you doing, bro? Excellent to see you as well. Good to see you. Fuck, I should take some initiative working off that extra weight. Right, isn't he? Oh, I forgot to bring the rebar with me. Sorry, I forgot the rebar. Oh, yeah, no, I could make the rebar. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I've got rebar. Okay, let's get rebar. I want to try and make another platform area. And I want to do it in concrete if I can. Before 7 day hits tonight, right? Before the day 14 horde arrives. Because obviously the rest of the platform area that I make, I want it all to be out of concrete because it's better. So I might as well start now and make as much of it out of concrete as I possibly can. It just makes sense. Rather than have to change it later on or beef it up. Boom. Let's put some wood on it. Of course, it does always amaze me how you put wood around the outside. Okay. And I'm now going to fill it with liquid concrete. Although really it should be liquid cement, but never mind. But I'm going to fill it with liquid concrete. And it doesn't fall out the bottom. I'm not sure. I don't know. Let's not question it too much, though. As long as it works. Spike damage area has been reduced. Well, thank God for that, to be honest with you. Because that was just ridiculous, wasn't it? It was just stupid before. You were getting wrecked by spikes when you were nowhere near them. Right, Sinistra? Like they put in some strawberries. Yeah. It's not blood anymore, it's strawberry juice. Bears can use ladders. Jesus Christ. My grandmother had a surgery to replace a bad kneecap. After that, she got the nickname Iron Knee. Wow, terror. Well, I have two titanium plates in my jaw. Am I titanium jaw man? Did you see the latest patch note? Yeah, I did, yeah. Yeah, the spikes, that pinkish, stupid texture is stupid. There's no other way of putting it. It is stupid. It's a very stupid texture. And I don't know why they changed it, because the old texture was pretty good, honestly. The old texture I thought was pretty damn good, right? I mean, did you guys not think that? I thought the old texture was pretty freaking good, honestly. I thought it was pretty good. Have I done that at the wrong fucking level? I did. What a dick. Shit. They're at the wrong level. Fuck. No one said a thing, you twerps. No one corrected me. Okay. Right. Let's do some more. I know, exactly, Raul. Yeah, GG, right? What a twerp. I'll just let the blocks below it just be sacrificial blocks. They can just get wrecked. And I don't have to worry about it. No, I didn't know what I was doing at all. I have no idea what I'm doing. I have no clue, apparently. Oh, we need more concrete. And we're running out of time now to be doing this crap. Damn. Okay. Giant mushroom farm. There it is. Should make a jacuzzi inside. Right, Sinus? There we go. More concrete mix. More crushed sand. More cement mix to be made. And I need more. Only got 10. Freaking. What's it left anyway? 10 wood in there. Do that. That. Put some more wood in there. All I keep seeing is field up the top right. Like, I've just failed something already. Which I did, I guess, just now. But that's not the point. It's totally not the point. But yes, I did fail. I don't really want rebar frames. I want, like, trussing or iron bars. And that was at the wrong level anyway. Do I want trussing again? I like the look. I do like the look of the trussing, I'll be honest with you. I think it looks better than the other shit and the iron bars. I think it looks better. If I had a stoic bob, right? If only I had a stoic bob. I have no stoic bob available. Construction tools going up just by repairing stuff, which is cool. Shows that obviously that works, which is great. I think trussing is the way to go, man. Trussing just looks the part, doesn't it? I hate that whole iron bars look. It's just me, I know, but I hate it. Oh, it looks just so terrible. Looks so terrible. The whole iron bars thing. I'm just not keen. Not keen, you know. Wood. I'll just go with 40. And we'll put a pick in there to smelt. Pick in there to smelt. And we want some trussing. How do I make trussing now? Metal trussing, please. Okay, it's 40 iron and a clay. What? How many do I get? Just one. Holy moly. That's expensive. It used to be super cheap. It used to be super cheap. If this is really low durability, I'm going to be quite annoyed. They've totally nerfed trussing. Like, damn. Holy God. Well, there will be Terror Jester in the future, right? There will be human NPCs and stuff and, like, safe zones and things like that. They're planning on that kind of thing. How much are the iron bars? They're 20 and 4. And what do you get? How many do you get for that? You get one. So the trussing is twice as expensive as the iron bars. Yeah, they did nerf all the resource gain from all the things, to be honest. They nerfed it all. At least it feels like it. It does feel like they've nerfed it. Let's put these down and see what the durability of them is like. It could be really bad, and then we could be really upset. Well, it's 40 iron in the forge, so actually it's 8, isn't it? It's actually 8 iron, like scrap iron or whatever. That's rebar. It's got 1,000 dura that this time around, so it has more durability. But that still seems... I mean, the iron bars are like 2,500 or something, aren't they? And they've really, really buffed the iron bars, haven't they? They've like super buffed the iron bars, am I correct? I'm pretty sure they've absolutely super buffed the iron bars. Someone please tell me if I'm wrong on that. So they've really buffed the iron bars and they've nerfed the crap out of trussing. Trussing used to be a good, simple, disposable, throwaway block. Not a problem. But now it seems like, whoa, wait a minute. Takes quite a bit to craft it now. So I have to now worry about when the police wreck it. And I have to think of that as a concern. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's 2.5k iron bars now. They're 2.5k, and yet they take half as much iron. You can still shoot through the trussing according to the block description. It says it in the block description. So it's obviously meant to be shot through, even if maybe it's bugged, I don't know. But it is meant to be shot through. Can't be shot through. But I can't believe that the iron bars take half as much iron and have 2.5 times the durability. Yeah, but you can't remove trussing either, Screech. It's trussing, not rebar. It's different. It's trussing. It blocked police spit before anyway, Terror. It blocked it before anyway. The police used to spit and break the trussing. So it blocked it before anyway. But I can't believe they would make iron bars that take half the iron, 2.5 times the durability. Of metal trussing. That makes, like, little to no sense to me. Is it just me? That seems to make no sense. Oh, what am I doing? I've got some more concrete mix, good. What do I need for more? I need stones. And I need cement, right? Take those for science. It's now, of course, 20 to 7. I don't know, Ridge, but it still seems... I don't know. But it's half the iron. It just makes metal trussing. Because equivalently, they pretty much do the same thing. Right? Don't they? I mean, the two blocks are pretty much the same thing. They're interchangeable. They both allow you to shoot through, and they're just a block that you can see and shoot through. Now, for them both to be interchangeable in that way, it's a bit naff that one of them takes half the iron and has 2.5 times the durability. I think. I don't know. That seems wrong. Dare I say it. Yeah, right. Yeah, structural integrity, I guess. I mean, trussing is meant to be a much stronger block. I understand that. But still, it seems a bit... harsh. I don't know. With frames. Okay, I'll do my up and down. Spikes. This is, of course, day 14 Horde, which shouldn't, I think, be too much of an issue. I don't think we even get cops on the day 14 Horde. If we do, I could be in trouble, actually. But I don't think we get cops. So, we should be good. I was watching a streamer last night, and they were playing on Insane. And I hosted them, actually, so some of you might have seen. They were playing on Insane as well. It was a woman and her partner, I assume. I never seem to see any... And I don't mean this to be derogatory in any way. You know me, I'm not sexist. But I never seem to see women on difficult settings who play solo. It's always, always a woman on really hard settings. And you think, ah, awesome, this is refreshing. Let's see how she does. This is great. I'm, you know, really big up. This is amazing. This is cool. Good on you. Good to see. And then I investigate the channel and find out that actually it's someone else playing. And she's just kind of like the front for it. I'm sure that's not the case. I'm sure she is just as capable. But it always appears that way when you see the channel at first, right? Until you investigate further and watch the channel for a little bit longer. Right, and she was good, and she knew what she was doing and all that, so it wasn't the case last night, but I did worry that when I saw it at first. I thought, oh, here we go. It's someone who's got really difficult settings, and they're going to be really awesome, and then you go into the channel and you think, oh, it's actually a woman who's just no idea, playing 7 Days to Die, being a front for the camera while her boyfriend does all the fucking work. But it didn't turn out to be that case. It didn't turn out to be that case last night. She actually did know what she was doing, right? Do you know what I'm saying, though, you badgy, don't you? Right? And I don't mean that to be in a sexist way, because I know there are so many women that watch this channel that are good at 7 Days to Die and know what they're doing, right? But it's just, it's so disheartening when I watch a stream and I think, oh, wow, someone's playing this and they're really good at it, or, you know, someone's playing this for a real good challenge. Even if they're not good at it, they're playing it for a real good challenge. They're giving it a go and so on, and you look at the stream and you just think, actually, it's just someone who's being a cover and, you know, being a... It's a real shame, to be honest. There we go. Let's block that off. Just for now. So we actually get blocks to do this properly, because that has to be done properly with concrete blocks. So we've got some spikes down. We've got some weird fucking ass pillars. It's a real shame, to be honest. There we go. Let's block that off. Just for now. So we actually get blocks to do this properly, because that has to be done properly with concrete blocks. So we've got some spikes down. We've got some weird fucking ass pillars. yeah. Exactly. Decisive Wand is a good example, right? You know, it's an absolutely perfectly good example. And Palm off Cage's stream. And there are many, many, many examples. It's not like they're even a minority. It's just that, unfortunately, the even smaller minority of those who adopt that method of having a woman doing the streaming while someone else is actually doing the work for them on what is quite a challenging game, demeans the ability of those that play it and can do it properly, right? It does demean it. It's unfortunate. No, I haven't. It is on pretty difficult settings, so I don't have all that stuff. No. difficulty is on Insane. The loot is on 25%. The zombies are on 150%. There are no airdrops. Having them on always run as well would just be fucking mental. Absolutely mental. Yeah, she does hold her own absolutely well. Yeah, I agree. Completely. Yeah. Craven would be another good example. Be another very good example. No, she is playing the game. They are playing the game to her, but there's playing the game and there's playing the game. Do you know what I mean? You know. There's playing the game and playing the game. Exactly. I just mean being carried, you know? Exactly, another elk. Exactly. 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 Yeah. So it's not really the same thing. It's not the same thing at all, in fact. Right? So we've got our torch. We've got very little else. We're hoping that all the zombies will just die on spikes because we've got nothing else, really. Same sort of similar defense as what we had last update on Alpha 13. I'm hoping, because we'll probably have spider zombies, I'm not sure if they'll actually be able to climb up some of these areas. They may be able to, in which case I could be in the shit. They may actually be able to climb up some of these areas, though. Like around here, etc. Like around the corner, see there? They might be able to climb up and just come and give me a load of shit. So, I don't know. But we'll see. But we will see. So, if we get in trouble, we'll try and deal with it. I'm not sure that we'll be able to deal with it, but we'll do our best. I don't really know if I could put anything... I don't know. Might as well make another wooden club. Might as well have a fresh one. Might as well have a fresh one. No, Groznak. No. Yeah, I know. I know how it works, Groznak. I've got about 2,000 hours in the game. I'm aware of that. But thanks. I do know. But I haven't really pimped out the entire house or anything yet. I haven't really done much to it, to be honest. You're young. Yeah, of course you're young. Right, so when it gets to nighttime, of course, we will be pausing the game. As we always have a break every hour at nighttime, we have a break. And so because it's going to be Horde night, then we won't be able to have our normal break. So what we'll do is we'll have a quick pause of the game in order to enable us. Have I got any grass? I haven't got any grass. Great. So what we'll do is we'll have a pause of the game in order to enable us to have our normal hourly break, and then we'll come back, we'll unpause it, and then we'll play. So I'm just going to make sure that they actually are on the way. We're undetected at the minute. As soon as we become detected, we'll know that zombies are incoming. There they are, you can actually see them. Yeah, they're incoming. We are hunted, so we're going to pause the game, and we're going to quickly have our break every hour on this channel. We have a bit of responsible gaming break, so we have a little of 2 or 3 minutes just to give you a chance to go and get a coffee and snack or whatever, go to the toilet, go have a cigarette. Me as well, I'm going to quickly go and make a coffee because my coffee's run out and my throat is dying. I'm not particularly well at the minute. It is terrifying, Groznak. There are lots of different ways to up the difficulty in this game. Having always run zombies is a fairly extreme way, to be honest. It makes it very challenging, but it also makes it very exciting. So, you know, whichever is the best for you, right? Whichever you prefer. I'm a bit of a purist zombie kind of person, like a 7 Days to Die zombie kind of person. Not 7 Days to Die, like a The Walking Dead kind of zombie person. So I would actually prefer them to be walking all the time, to be honest with you. But I don't. I have it where they run at night, just to keep with the theme of the game. But I would prefer if they walked all the time. It makes no sense to me that zombies would suddenly run because it's dark. It makes no logical sense. But I keep it as it is. But everything else is on quite difficult settings. Right, so we'll be back. We'll be right back in about 2 or 3 minutes. I will not be long. I need to get myself a coffee and go to the toilet, come straight back. I'll see you very, very soon, guys. Very soon. Don't go anywhere. Hey, how you doing, Robin Hood? How you doing? You all right? Hey, Drunken Zombie, how you doing as well? Good to see you. Exactly. I'm getting carried by chair. Exactly. We could be fortunate here because the zombies are coming from that direction. Meaning spider zombies, etc. Hopefully can be dealt with by the spikes before they go to an area where they'll climb up. We could be fortunate. Could be. We may not be, but we could be fortunate. So obviously we've got this whole platform that we can walk around on. And the zombies should come to us. So they'll keep moving around in the direction that we govern. I haven't seen any cops or anything yet, which is a good thing. A very good thing. It is quite jittery, I'll be honest. The FPS is a little bit jittery right now. Noise will obviously be an issue, so be careful, those that are in workplaces or things like that. Noise will be a problem during the horde. Always is. But they seem to be enjoying themselves nicely, really. They seem to be enjoying themselves. And I haven't seen any spider zombies. Have you seen any spider zombies? I haven't seen any. Just ordinary run-the-mill at the moment. Ordinary run-the-mill at the moment. Nothing special. Nothing weird. Could take them over this other side here, just to get them excited over here. Use these spikes over this side as well. We should be able to clear them all out with a bit of luck. There seem to be quite a few, which is disheartening. That's it. Hey Biffin, how you doing, man? Good to see you. As the last of the cement upgrades dry out, right? Perfect timing, I'd have thought. Perfect timing. It's fantastic. Okay. We need to encourage these boyos to get on spikes that are available. If we can. There still seems to be more coming, which is, I'll be honest, worrying. Not sure we have, because we haven't got at the minute, don't forget, we haven't got a method to go all the way around our house. So all we can do is go inside the house and lure them from the inside, like, unless we can kill them all by the spikes outside. So unless we can kill them by the spikes outside, we're going to be a little bit in trouble, actually. Chair is the real MVP, right, Darker? I agree. I totally agree. So keep going. Keep coming. Come over here, there's more spikes over here. There's like plenty of spikes, guys. Have you not noticed? There's loads of spikes over here. You can, there's lots for you to like jump on and stuff. Fill your boots. Plenty of spikes available. You don't have to crowd around like one or two spikes. You can, yeah, that's it. Go find your own spike. Each of you just find your own spike and have fun. Dog, you're just crazy. Yeah. Well, some of them are finding their own spikes. Some of them are just being a bit silly. Some of you are just being a little bit silly right now. You need to find your own spike, please. It doesn't appear to be any cops or ferals in this one, no. This is only a day 14 horde, don't forget. I think day 21 is the first time you get cops or ferals. I think you get one or two ferals at day 21. And you get a few cops. So I think it's the first properly threatening horde is day 21. How are we doing? All the spikes seem to have all been used up over here. They're all gone. Are we still spawning? We're still spawning. Okay, a little bit in worried. A little bit worried now. I'm a little bit concerned, if I'm on it. That sounds like a fucking spider zombie. Okay, I'm now a lot concerned. Thoroughly concerned. Let's get rid of this. It, bring them around a little bit further. There's more spikes to play with. Yo, guys. That spider zombie's over there trapped in the wood. Hey Spidey. Seriously dog, calm down. There seems to be a lot of them for a day 14 horde, I'll be honest. Does seem to be a lot of them. In fact, it's day 14, doesn't seem to have deterred them from coming out in force. And we ran out of wood frames, because we're stupid. Come on then. Are we still coming? You're making your way slowly. Okay, I understand. That frickin' thing there. Seriously, bro, you need to calm yourself down a little bit, if you can't. How is that not hitting him? I don't understand. Is it hitting him? He's dead. Apparently it did hit him. Yo! Dudes! How many dudes we got left? We got a break dancer. And a crawling Elvis. Let's go. Come over here then. Breakdancer and crawling Elvis. Hey Freeze, how you doing, man? You did, Blackpoint. How you doing? Hey, no worries, Slid. He should have said it to me himself. I was in his channel yesterday. And that's a pretty nice bag that he made for you, isn't it, Freeze? I was watching yesterday. I was watching the King yesterday. Seeing how he's doing. Checking out his bag making and then his 7 days that I stream afterwards. He made you a very nice bag, I thought. Should we say sock? Yeah. The sock that he made for you, Freeze. I'm not really sure what you're going to use that for, but, you know, each to his own, right? Each to his own. I bet you are. For your dice. Yeah, my voice is not good. It's not good, honestly. Yeah, you were going to get some dwarven dice for it, right, Freeze? That red and black bag that he's made for you is quite cool. It's quite cool. It's quite impressive. So we're still hunted. These doofuses obviously don't want to die. Nor do they want to get hit by an arrow, apparently. But I think we've pretty much done the horde. The horde's pretty much dead. So, you know, chicks dig it. Yeah, a sock for your dice. The bag did look great, Rattle, yeah. I have played War Thunder Tactical in the past. I haven't played it for a very long time. I don't even know if I can still access my account and stuff. I don't know. But I haven't played it for a very long time. Good game, though. It's only a good game if you play with people, though. And I don't know people to play it with. Nobody likes me, so I don't play it with anyone. But it's a very good game. How did I get a lump of coal? I got a lump of coal out of that Really? Really? I got a lump of coal? Off that charcoaled block? That's surprising. A little bit, if I'm honest. So annoying finding it there. Wood frames, let's just make a whole bucket full of them. Yeah, I got coal from the burnt out block, right? But you didn't get coal from it before, that's a new thing. Look, I got coal from it. From the burnt out block. Solo, Dantev. Solo. Right, drunken zombie? It's like a carrot? What? In a block named Charcoal? Well, yeah, alright, whatever. Shh. Stop making it complicated. That's not the level I wanted at, is it? It's at that level. Loads of charcoal in the burnt biome. Yeah. I've just never... It's a new thing. You never used to get charcoal from that block. So, I'm surprised because it's a new thing. I have plenty of coal, to be quite honest. I have quite a lot at the moment. I'm still hunted. Why am I still hunted? Confusing. Oh, Gravy, seriously, that thunder was just... That's amazing. I made a highlight of that, Gravy. I did make a highlight of it. I was really impressed by the weather, honestly. Really impressed. Still am. The weather changes they've made are amazing. Really, really good. Really good changes. I bet I can't make a fucking bastard. I've no stone, nothing. No stone, no plant fibers. I might as well just not exist. I might as well not exist. That's how little stuff I have. I'll just not exist here. Check me out, not existing. Where you at? Where you at? What are you doing down there, you fucking prat? Well, that pissed you off, didn't it? There you go. Have some of that, dude. Dead. Log spike steel level. Oh. Really? Really? Now that's something I might have to engorge myself on. Are they exceptionally durable, Black Point? Are they really durable is the point. I don't mind whether they do little damage. I just want them to be really, really durable. What are you excited about, Decisive? And we were just talking about capable women in gaming when you heard your name earlier on, Decisive One. That's all it was. Right, Slade. Lure them into a house to set fire to it. Not that I would do that anyway. That's not the point. You're going to get your kids' names tattooed on me with a spirally line with butterflies today. You know what they say about tattoos, though, Decisive? What about in the future, if one of your kids, you don't like them anymore? What are you going to do? Hey, River Lizard. How you doing? You're really impressed seeing your FPS drop worse than the snow. What do you mean? What happened with your FPS? Why did you have an issue, Blackpoint? Hope they had lockpicking in the game. I don't know about that. There's lots of things. I was watching Eando stream yesterday morning. I was hosting him yesterday morning. Apparently I just leveled up. I didn't do anything. I was watching Eando stream yesterday morning. And I'm wary of people giving suggestions that would be... I think you need to... There's lots of things we could add to this game, which, yes, would make it a little bit better. But you think, for the amount of time and effort to go into that particular suggestion, does it really add to what the concept of the game is? Like... like yesterday in Eando's stream, someone suggested that you go to a car and you're able to completely strip it down with just a wrench, right? And they're like, well, that's just silly. Maybe you could only strip down the first layer with a wrench or something, and then you need more tools in order to be able to strip the rest down. And I'm sitting there thinking, is it really going to add anything to the game? To the point of the game, because Eando was like, yeah, that's a really good idea, bro. And I'm thinking, yeah, every little thing that we could add would obviously add to the game, right? And I get that. But I just think some things you're adding just for the sake of adding, rather than is it actually going to add anything to our gameplay or to our fun in the game? And I'm thinking, if I added extra tool sets that I had to get just to strip down the last three quarters of a car, would that really add anything to my gaming experience? I mean, yes, it might be more realistic. You obviously can't strip a car down just, you know, with a wrench. But do I really care about that particular set of realism? The same with the lockpicking thing. Do I really need to use a lockpick, or can I not just break a door down? It's an apocalypse. Is it likely that every single one of us in an apocalypse is suddenly a lockpicking expert? I mean, I think I'm more likely to break the door down, to be honest. You know, I don't know. I mean, would it add to the game? Maybe, I guess. I just think some things that could be added to the game don't really add to the game. And I think we've got to be careful which ones we back and which ones we don't. Do you know what I mean? Which ones we turn around and go, this is freaking, let's do this. Or which ones we just go, well, that'd be really cool, but it's not really needed. It would be cool if we had lockpicking. Yeah, it would be cool. But do we really need it? I don't know. I'm not sure. The same as Miss Cree's desire to bareback ride bears. I'm not really sure that's a necessary thing. Do you know what I mean? There's lots of other things from other different games and stuff that could obviously be pulled into this game and make it amazing and make it more engrossing and stuff. But I can imagine them spending 3 months trying to do an alpha update just to add lockpicking and just think, do I really care about?